after the topic of normal shift. Now the next topic is total internal reflection. This is the new topic, total internal reflection, TIR, total internal reflection. You see this diagram, I make this diagram here, two medium, rare medium and denser medium, and this is the interface of both the medium. This line indicates the interface. So when the light from the denser medium transmit to the rarer medium, you see if it is fall normally, 96% of light transmit and 4% of light reflect back inside, means transmission and reflection both takes place. If the light falls at any other angle, then you see that 93% of light transmit and 7% of light reflect inside the medium. Now we changing the angle of incidence in the denser medium. Suppose that angle theta 1 is the angle of incidence in denser medium and angle theta 2 is the angle in rarer medium. Light moves away from the normal when the light passes in the rarer medium. So angle theta 2 is more than angle theta 1. Now again here, 80% of light is refracted and 20% light reflects. Keep on changing the angle of incidence in denser medium. We obtain one angle for which the angle of refraction is 90 degrees, and this light ray grazes the surface. Ye light ray satah se nikalti hai aise. For the angle of incidence in denser medium for which the angle of refraction is 90 degrees, this angle is known as critical angle. Critical angle. And if this angle increase further, this angle is more than critical angle, and for this angle the light totally reflects back into the denser medium. There is no refraction takes place, no light go outside, 100% light moves inside the denser medium. That's why it is phenomena known as total internal reflection. Total internal reflection means puri puri light andar hi reflect ho gayi, 100% light reflects back inside the medium. This relation is Snell's law, D for denser and R for rarer I use here. ND means refractive index of denser medium with the product of sine theta 1 is equal to refractive index of rarer medium with product of sine theta 2. This both will equal. This is Snell's law. Now if angle of incidence keep on changing, after reaching this angle the angle of refraction is 90 degrees, and when the angle of incidence is more than critical angle, the total light reflects back. So this is the relation, this is the phenomena known as total reflection. If theta 1 approaches to theta c, means angle of incidence approaches to critical angle, then theta 2 in the rarer medium become 90 degrees. Angle of incidence beyond theta c, no refracted ray obtained and 100% light reflects back into the first medium. This is a figure 9.2 on page number 320 in NCERT book. You see this figure. I have drawn this figure for your convenience in the page. Now you see this. This is angle IC at which the refracted ray passing through the surface, and when this angle of incidence more than critical angle, the light totally reflect back inside the denser medium. This is totally reflected ray, and these are the partial reflected ray and refracted ray. This figure is important. You make this diagram on a copy. If I replace the value of theta 1 and theta 2 with this theta c and 90 in this Snell's law, then it will be ND sin theta c is equal to NR sin 90 degrees, or sin theta c is equal to NR upon ND sin 90, and value of sine 90 is 1, since sine 90 is equal to 1, therefore sine theta c is equal to nr upon nd is equal to nrd, or sine theta is equal to 1 upon n dr. This is the relation between theta and the refractive index. On the page number 320, there is a one table 9.1, and in this table there are different medium: water, crown glass the type of glass, dense flint glass and diamond, whose refractive indices are given. 1.33, 1.52, 1.62 and 2.42 of diamond. So here we are seeing that the refractive index of diamond is very high, and the critical angle for these is 48.75 for water and crown glass and everything. The critical angle is given. So if the light enters more than this angle, then it will be totally reflected inside the medium. This table is very important. This will give you an idea that what is the meaning of this critical angle. And here you see, this line is also very important. See from the book and note it down on your copy. Now here the next topic is demonstration for total internal reflection. This you can do at your home. This is the demonstration. How can you perform this experiment at your home? In this, everything is written over here. You can take a few drop of milk or any other suspension to water, and instead to that water become little turbid, and take a laser pointer pen, you can take that laser pointer and shine it beam through the turbid water. You will find that the path of beam inside the water shining brightly. This is the way then how can you perform the experiment, and the diagram is given here. In this, it is a beaker, and the water is taken over here, and the laser point is in this direction. You see the light is going in this direction, and some part of light is reflect and some part of light is refract back. After changing this angle, you change this angle of the laser point, and after some time you see that the total light is reflecting back into the liquid what we had taken inside this beaker. So this is the phenomena how the total reflection takes place. This you can read from a book and understand it is a demonstration. Now on the page number 321, topic 9.4.1, there are few topics given based on total internal reflection. One is mirage. It was in the class 10 syllabus also, and I explained in class 10 this thing. You read this topic from your book and make your notes with the help of diagram, and if you ask, I will explain it in the next video. But I think that you can understand this, what is the mirage. Aur main isme add kar dun ki garmiyon ke dinon mein jab hum log kabhi bahar car se jate hain to dekhte hain road par kahin par lagta hai ki pani bhara hua hai, lekin jab hum paas pahunchte hain to aisa lagta hai ki wahan pani nahi hai. To ye ek jo dur se dikhne par humko appearance ho raha hai is cheez ka, ye hamare liye illusion hai, and this illusion is also known as mirage. To mirage ko padhna, you read it from book. And the topic is on hot summer day, the air near the ground become hotter, and the air at higher level. You read and you can understand, I know very well. You see this diagram. Compare the diagram and make your own notes. The next is on the page number 322, figure 9.15. This figure is very important. Question asked on this content. These are three prism. You see 45, 45 and 90. Right angle prism. Isko bolte hain. This is right angle prism. And you see that light is coming from an object. Object is AB. Light is coming from the object. And if this is a normal, this is 45. This is also 45. This is 90. And the air and glass interface, the critical angle is 42. But light is falling at more than 42, means more than critical angle. So light is totally reflected. You see, this light is totally reflected from the point B and A also. Now you see that object AB is now A dash B dash with respect to this object. It changes its direction 90 degree. So to rotate the image, we use this right angle prism. You see in this figure also, this is rotated 180 degree. Light coming from B and A, you make a diagram on your copy and you will understand that what is the purpose of this prism. Here also you see this figure number C. AB is now inverted, A dash B dash. This is also the prism which is used to rotate the images. This is written over here, prism. And you see the figure 9.16. Figure 9.16 is the figure for optical fiber. This is optical fiber. And if you see this figure, there are two layer. One, it is written low end refractive index. Low refractive index ki outer layer. And inside this, this is a high refractive index. If light go inside this tube, or this is a pipe inside this tube, light suffers total reflection. Light suffers total reflection, and the light reflected many times without losing its energy. And this is optical fiber used in the communication. You read it from here, optical fiber written here, and you read from this content and make your own short note. ऑप्टिकल फाइबर का एक इस्तेमाल हम लोगों ने देखा होगा आप लोगों ने कि एक फ्लावर वाज आता है, शो लैम्प, डेकोरेटिव लैम्प बोलते हैं उसको, उसमें जब हम प्लग लगाकर उसको लाइट को ऑन करते हैं तो उसके किनारों पर यहाँ पर हल्के हल्के से लाइट जलती दिखाई पड़ती हैं. दिस इज ऑल्सो द एग्जाम्पल ऑफ ऑप्टिकल फाइबर. ऑप्टिकल फाइबर का इस्तेमाल एंडोस्कोपी में होता है. डॉक्टर यूज़ करते हैं इसको इंटरनल ऑर्गन देखने के लिए. दे इंसर्ट इट इनटू द बॉडी एंड ऑन द monitor, they observe the organ inside without operating them. Read it from book and make your own notes. After that, I will start the next topic, refraction at spherical surface by lenses, in the next video.